Уважаемые коллеги,
dear colleagues, I really feel you. It is the third day of the Congress, and everybody is tired. My task is unenviable. I'm the last speaker, but I'll do my best not to be overly boring. But this is where we live, on the schematic. It's the Earth on the left and Asgardia on the right, our digital nation. And on this image, it's fully digitized to reflect the Earth. We exist together, and we don't meddle with each other. So let's look at the primary objectives of Asgardia in terms of science and technology, politics, and economics. Let's start with the core mission of Asgardia, namely, the birth of the first child in space. Once that happens, it will mean a simple fact. The humankind will be independent from its point of birth, planet Earth, and it could continue eternal existence. Space flight is similar to maritime navigation, and it's about time that humanity became ready to depart from its original port and travel to unknown destinations. But we need to resolve two tasks, namely, deliver artificial gravity, and here you see a symbolic lower semisphere on the slide, and also deliver protection from space radiation. It's the upper symbolic semisphere. Together, they represent the space arc, similar to the Noah's Ark. And Asgardian space module on the ISS could be its first implementation. The second phase should be an independent Asgardian arc with artificial gravity on an Earth orbit, next on the lunar orbit, and finally the space arc should turn into a starship capable of carrying a sufficient number of people for dozens of years. In its entirety, the Asgardian infrastructure should represent the following components: Earth-based, near-Earth, near-lunar, lunar, and stellar. The Earth-based, in its key features, should contain launch sites, rockets, missiles, production facilities, control centers, and individual communication gadgets for the Asgardians. The near Earth should comprise a swarm of low-orbit satellite clusters, including delivery of the global internet without ground-based assets, and a high-orbit satellite cluster delivering all the functions of the digital nation. Going forward, space arcs and the space fleet. The near-lunar should comprise a satellite cluster and space arcs on the lunar orbit. And the stellar phase is the starship based on the original space arcs. All those and other scientific aspects will be addressed in detail at the first Asgardian Science and Investment Congress to take place in June this year in the city of Brugge. Now let's move on to the political aspect of Asgardia's development. Asgardia is a space nation. However, for the time being, it is still on Earth, and it requires appropriate representation. For the time being, the headquarters of Asgardia are in Vienna, because Austria is a neutral nation. It's not member of any military political alliance on Earth, and it is also host to the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs. Here, we registered our first non-governmental, non-commercial civil society organization, simply an NGO, Asgardia, under the Austrian law. Similar NGOs will need to be established on all the six continents on Earth: Eurasia, North and South Americas, Africa, Australia, and the Antarctic. Those will be our continental representation offices. The next phase is subcontinental offices in individual countries, that they will operate under general agreements between Asgardian communities and function as associations without legal personality. As governments on Earth recognize Asgardia, those representative offices will be transformed into embassies and consular offices. Let me also address the Asgardian population structure and opportunities for social mobility. Our ultimate objective is 2% of the population on Earth, in other words, approximately 150 million Asgardians, and we're currently looking at 7 levels of hierarchy in the society. Asgardians, free participation, children, people in retirement, then residents, and this is associated with the annual residential fee, voting rights, various preferences and benefits, then citizens. This is based on payment for the citizenship certificate, the right to be elected, participation in the redistribution of budget surpluses, purchase of shares in investment projects at nominal prices. The next level is mayors in cities with sufficient numbers of Asgardians. The next tier is prefects in large regions in individual countries on Earth. The next level is governors in regions on various continents. And the next level is members of parliament who will, for all practical purposes, act as our ambassadors in 150 largest countries on Earth. Means of social mobility of the so-called social elevators, as well as career opportunities, will not simply be associated with the appropriate status. They will also depend on budgetary redistribution to various levels of hierarchy, delegation of managerial and business authority, as well as evolution of parliaments on continents and subcontinents, and the evolution of governments and courts. The key element for the internal market and the overall market on Earth should be the quality of individual Asgardians. That's why we focus on positive selection. In the final phase of the political construction of Asgardia should be its admission to the United Nations as a full-fledged member. And finally, let me address the economic development of Asgardia. Asgardian economy remains extremely volatile. The current inflows of residential fees are in no sense sufficient to cover our current outlays, and this has a very negative impact on my family budget, and apparently also on your individual budgets, because so far you haven't received a single salary. This is why the key objective in terms of economics is to produce a fully balanced budget for Asgardia for 2020. All in all, the approach to building the Asgardian economy should be the following. Residential fees should cover only the current budget of the nation. They may not be used for investment projects. Fees for the citizenship certificates should go into investment projects. First and foremost, our leading investment holding, the Asgardia AG, also registered here in Vienna. Those payments should give Asgardia ownership rights over the Asgardia AG holding. There is a caveat. The first 7 million of Asgardian nationals will have a privileged right to purchase shares in the Asgardia AG parent company, and those shares will be sold to them at their nominal prices for all investment projects. This is a mechanism for them not only to enjoy the budgetary surpluses and their redistribution, but also to receive dividends and distributions directly from the primary investment holding. 7 global investors from the first wave will also receive shares in Asgardia AG, as well as positions in the Supreme Space Council. Future Asgardians and investors of the second wave will also have access free access limit sized to investment projects, and there will be a very large range of such projects to pick from global, such as space launch sites or lunar settlements, to local franchises, including space cafes and space shops. In addition to investment projects, Asgardian revenue should also come from traditional taxation, banking transactions, delivery of a wide range of government services, and the transactions in the domestic market for digital goods and services, as well as many other sources. We will also need to establish a national bank and a national stock exchange. Just to conclude, let me say a few words. Yesterday, one of the journalists started a question by saying, would you please tell me, once Asgardia becomes reality, and I cut him off immediately, because Asgardia is already reality. That's what I said, and this is true. I don't know what will happen next in Asgardia, but even today, the very fact that all of us are here today, the Asgardian leadership of Earthlings from 10 nations of the world, parliamentarians from 42 nations, and Asgardians from 200 countries, we have all proven that Asgardia has become reality. I thank you all for your faith in Asgardia. Let's all join our efforts to make sure that the flame of hope we have kindled for the eternal existence of humanity in the endless universe never dies out. Thank you very much.